Welcome, welcome. The time has come to select one courageous young man and woman for the honor of representing District 12 in the 74th annual Hunger Games.
It's your first year, Prim. Your name's only been in there once. They're not gonna pick you.
Our tributes, Peter Mallark and Katniss Everdeen.
They just want a good show, that's all they want.
It's 24 of a scale, only one comes out.
The story never lets up. You know, I think that's what I felt when I read the book. You know, I couldn't turn the pages fast enough. I was fascinated, stunned, shocked, emotionally engaged. I cared about this girl immediately. And I was so in her shoes, and she was so real to me, that there were very few stories that grabbed me by the throat and yanked me through the narrative, and I put the book down, and I was just shocked when I did. And so I think we've done that in the film. I think that it's just this urgent, compelling, relentless narrative of somebody who is thrust into these circumstances that are so overwhelming, navigates them, changes, grows, defies them, and ultimately triumphs. It's a wonderful, complete story in which that character grows in such a rich, amazing way that, you don't find these very often.
And Jennifer Lawrence is so incredibly talented. And what I was thinking was it the moment where you saw her skinning a squirrel where you were like, yeah, this girl's a survivalist?
No, it was the audition. It was the audition. I was so hammered. Well, first of all, Winter's Bone. You know, I mean, I saw one. Are you kidding me? Really? And I'd seen her in other stuff, too. And I remember noticing her in another movie where I just went, wow, this girl's really special. There's something going on here that's just different than everything else in the frame, you know? And then I met with her, and I remember the meeting being over, just saying to the people I work with, I'd be stunned if I didn't cast this girl. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm pretty convinced this is the girl. And then she came in and read for me and just, like, blew me away. I mean, I was shocked at how good she was.
Be prepared to fight to the death.
This is the time to show them everything. Make sure they remember you.
It's a staple of literature that characters are thrust into an alien environment, you know, whether it's Gulliver's Travels or, you know, the examples, or Ulysses. I mean, the examples are limitless of people who leave the comfort of their own world, are thrust into alien circumstances, adapt to that, and grow as a result.
But
right?
These are children. It's children.
True. That's true. Listen, maybe that's why I was drawn to it. I mean, I thought that what she wrote was such a compelling protagonist, in part because of her ferocity, her independence, her drive for survival, the fact that she didn't trust anyone around her. I mean, she was almost an animal in that respect. I mean, she had the finely honed skills of a hunter. Mm-hmm. And her arc is she meets this boy who's this guileless, open-hearted, redemptive character who just has this adoration for her, which of course is something that she mistrusts completely. So, you know, Katniss's arc through the course of the story is someone who learns to trust her own trust, that she learns to trust what that instinct is, and she begins the story as someone who only wants to survive, and she ends the story by someone who's willing to die for something rather than kill an innocent person who she's grown to care for. So that's a beautiful, wonderful, long arc to a character.
I just keep wishing that I could think of a way to show them that they don't own me. If I'm gonna die, I wanna still be me.
I just can't afford to think like that.
You know, there's always going to be changes from the, you know, book to the screen. I mean, there always are. An example of which, but they're not bad. I mean, sometimes it's an opportunity, you know. And Suzanne looked at it the same way. You know, in the book, she's restricted to being in Katniss's point of view the whole time, right? But I have the ability to cut away on occasion, right? In the book, Suzanne has the luxury, not the luxury, she has the ability to be able to have Katniss speculate on what the Game Makers must be doing. Like, oh, they're manipulating me now. I know the Game Makers are doing this. I know the Game Makers are doing that. well, I can't shoot inside her head, so I can't do that, but I can cut to what they're doing. So it's just a difference in the cinematic versus the literary treatment of the material. It really kind of comes down to that. It was more of a collaboration that I've had with any of the other authors that I've worked with. It's the third adaptation that I've done now, and I wrote a draft. First, I talked extensively to Suzanne before I did a draft, and I told her what I felt the essence of that was. We were in great agreement. We had a wonderful conversation. Then I went and wrote a draft, and I sent it to her, and she was very excited about it, had some thoughts, came out to L.A. We started talking before I knew it, we were working together. It was kind of a surprising thing, actually. It began as a conversation, and before I even either of us realized what was happening, it had kind of morphed into a collaboration. So I said to her, well, this is crazy. We're working so well together. Why don't we just like do this officially and do the next draft together? And so I invited her into the process, and then she and I collaborated on a draft, which was a fantastic experience. And it was fun for me. I mean, I hadn't collaborated with anyone since Ann Spielberg on Big. So that was really a blast to be writing with someone again. And we had a terrific time.
So you're here to make me look pretty?
I'm here to help you make an impression.
There's been a lot of three, four. How many movies are there going to be?
I'm not sure.
How many have you signed on for?
I have committed to the next one.
Have you started filming it yet?
I have not started shooting, no.
But you already have a release date.
Yes, we already have a release date.
What sort of pressure does that put on the next script, the next shoot?
Well, not a ton, because I'm actually more concerned about the first release date than the second one. I mean, I have a release date on Hunger Games that's a little more immediate to me than Catching Fire, and I have 1,200 visual effects shots to put through the mill. So, you know, I'm not really looking at the next event horizon. I'm kind of looking at this one.
One.